Welcome to the St. Augustine's Priory 2020 Sports Awards. These sports awards are going to celebrate the achievement of the individuals, teams who have made progress in the 2019 and 2020 season. Obviously, due to the current conditions, these awards will take a slightly different format to normal, but we look forward to celebrating with you all soon. Though this year has been very different and looking ahead, it's hard to imagine when we're going to get back to playing our favourite games and get back on court and back on the pitch. It's really important that we recognise the progress and achievements that we have made throughout this year. We may reminisce about the fun and enjoyment about we had playing against our favourite teams or playing against our peers in our PE lesson. And I think this is a really important thing to do because who knows when it's going to be the next time that we're all going to be together. This evening you will hear all about our updates from our teams from all different year groups as well as our individual achievements that they have made. I'd like to commend you all on a fantastic remote learning and your positive engagement and attitude during this time. I've really enjoyed seeing all your sporting journeys and the sporting challenges you set yourself, really still keeping St. Augustine's Priory Sport as a prime focus during this time. I've loved the things such as the upper two 26 challenge, seeing 26 goals or 26 laps run around their gardens, the pass it on challenge, and thank you all for taking part, or the running club running to Canterbury, just to name a few highlights. Sporting at St. Augustine's continues to thrive, and moving forwards, I know this isn't possible without the amazing teachers and coaches and parents that we have. Normally, obviously, we'd give them all a huge round of applause, so please make sure you thank your parents for all they do for you at this time. I myself would like to make a personal big thank you to the PE department, Miss Nova, Miss Cross, Miss Hales and Mrs Lindsay, who always work tirelessly for you to ensure that you have all opportunities, even during this remote lockdown period. And to all our coaches, who without them, we could not offer the breadth of extracurricular opportunities that we do. So, to Mr. and Mrs. Matheson, Mr. Alejandro, Mr. Ferguson, Mr. Dello, Mr. Fazel and Mr. Kakuda, our gymnastic coaches, Ellie, Katie and Maria. And also a special mention to Mrs. Aresti Becker, who this year is stepping down from the swimming programme after 5 amazing years. We thank you all for all that you have done for us at St. Augustine's Priory this year. At this time, we would normally have a sports introductory speaker who would inspire us for the season ahead. I know that you're going to hear from many highlights from the year that will do that for you. But in this time, I'm going to leave you with a quote, which I think is quite prevalent during these times. This is from Mike Singletary, a NFL footballer. Do you know what my favourite part of the game is? The opportunity to play. Have a fantastic evening and congratulations to all our award winners. And I look forward to seeing you soon.
My netball poem by Sienna St. Paul, Form 3A. Netball is my favourite sport. No other sport comes near. You feel so alive when you're on the court, but remember to tie your hair. I play many times a week. I just cannot get enough. Although to run and run around the court can really be quite tough. I love playing with my teammates, catching to and fro, but when the sacred ball is in your hands, you have 3 seconds to let it go. We jostle for position, we pivot and we spin. Netball is a competitive sport, and of course we love to win. When you receive the ball, look for your mate, the one who has just found some space. Make sure your pass is true and straight, that's how you control the game. Be fast around the court, change direction, use your speed. Starve your opponents of possession, that's how you maintain your lead. Matches upon matches, tournaments near and far. I love to be a netball pro, and so to get there, I'll work hard. My teachers and my coaches, they are the best of the best. They push me to my limits and put me to the test. Remember, sports are not just about winning. It's also about making friends. Experiences shared together builds friendships that never end.
soul, but I'm not a soldier. I got soul, but I'm not a soldier. I got soul, but I'm not a soldier. I got soul, but I'm not a soldier.
This year, we have had a fun-filled and an eventful year in netball, with over 145 fixtures, 57 junior and 88 senior fixtures. It has been lovely to see so many players across both juniors and seniors progress in their various positions and observe how quickly their confidence has grown this season. Us as a department have seen a vast increase of numbers from juniors through to seniors that have attended netball club during morning, lunch and after school sessions. This year we have been fortunate enough to give a number of girls the opportunity to play up in older age groups, as well as two of our under 13s being selected to play in the under 14s Middlesex Schools tournament, to which they all played outstanding and qualified to the next round of the finals. Although unfortunately this was cancelled due to the coronavirus. We also entered our under 13s and under 14s into the Sister in Sports Cup, where the under 13s successfully got through to the fourth round of the cup, with the under 14s through to the fourth round of the plate. A number of girls from both juniors and seniors have joined clubs, local clubs such as Grasshoppers Netball Club this year, which has been great to see, and a number of girls being selected for Middlesex Satellite and Middlesex County Netball, resulting in their abilities to develop further. The girls are going from strength to strength, and I really look forward to seeing the girls advance further next year.
What an amazing season for our talented hockey players here at St. Augustine's. It has been fantastic to watch each and every one of you grow and flourish throughout this season. Many of you have attended hockey club every week wanting to develop your skills, and the astounding improvement was seen on the pitch. Overall this season we have had 21 junior fixtures and 73 senior fixtures, with some incredible performances, showing superb potential for the future. Having been very successful this season in many year groups, we also had some matches we learned from, and many of you showing your drive and perseverance to come back stronger in your next match. Thank you to all the girls who stepped up out of their comfort zone more than once to play up in older year groups. Your strength and resilience truly showed you could hold your own on the pitch. In March, we were lucky enough to take two under 13 teams to Birmingham to play in the Society of Heads tournament. Again, with some outstanding performances, with amazing goals being scored and saved. Congratulations to all girls who went away, and well done to the under 13 A team who came second. Another congratulations goes to the under 13 and under 11 Middlesex teams, who battled against strong teams, the weather, and late season injuries to still finish third place. It's an incredible achievement. Well done. Under 14s, what can I say? Every game during your Middlesex tournament, you turned up to win, and you showed some fantastic positional play and teamwork, displaying some of the best hockey I have seen so far. You deserved your promotion through to the Southern Regional Finals. Although it didn't go our way, a big congratulations on your achievements this season. You all fought hard, as many squads did. It has been tremendous to see so many of you joining hockey clubs outside of school, both in juniors and seniors. We currently have 11 senior students not only playing in their age group, but playing up for the senior women as well. A massive congratulations to those girls who made county and development hockey teams this season. That is a phenomenal effort on your behalf. I'm excited to see all of you on the pitch next season and see you all progress even further.
Cross country and distance running is fast becoming one of our strengths here at St. Augustine's Priory. Regularly, we have girls qualify for the next stages to represent Ealing or to represent Middlesex, which is a massive, 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 brilliant effort. A huge thank you must go to Mr. Alejandro and Mr. Ferguson for all of their work, taking the girls out on long runs, and especially setting up the virtual running club so that people can carry on running while we've been in lockdown and keeping up our fitness. Under the tutelage of Mr. Harnett and Mrs. Aresti, the swimming club has continued to grow and develop. The girls are hugely committed to their very early starts, and their performances are getting much, much more competitive in galas, with a number of girls now winning their races. We've also had the opportunity this year to try some water polo, which was amazing fun, and I hope we can try that again. Both Mr. Harnett and Mrs. Aresti have given up swimming this term, and I'd like to thank them so very much for everything they've done for us, and I wish them all the very best in the future. Girls football has seen a huge rise in popularity worldwide, and that is reflected here at St. Augustine's, where we now have good numbers turning out regularly in juniors and seniors. And we're also becoming much, much more increasingly competitive in our fixtures. A huge, massive thank you must go to Mr. Fazell, Mr. Matheson and Mr. Katkuda for our junior club, and Mr. Alejandro and Mr. Ferguson for the seniors. I really hope to see as many of you there next year and continue to improve. Our aesthetic activities continue to improve, and we now have good numbers participating in intermediate and advanced prep gymnastics through to junior gymnastics and into senior gymnastics. This has now given us a lovely pathway for girls to continue to develop their skills as they get older. Our Dynamite, our cheerleading squad, were working on a really special performance for their summer showcase, but unfortunately due to COVID-19 they were unable to perform it, so I do they hope they get to practice again next year. Thank you ever so much to all of our coaches, to Maria and to Katie, to Miss Kvetkova and any of the other staff that has come down and supervised. We couldn't do it without you, and we're so thankful. The enthusiasm for sport of our girls never ceases to amaze me. We've also put some teams out into loads of other sports this year, including sports hall athletics, where we did exceptionally well despite not having a sports hall. We've also put some teams out in badminton, trampolining and handball, with some success. A big thank you to all of the girls that give up their time so freely and really just have a go. We couldn't do it without you, and we're so proud.
I'll take it in, but don't look down.
'Cause I'm on top of the world, hey. I'm on top.
Hi girls, it gives me great pleasure to announce the most improved player of the year. We have taken into consideration the girls' ability across a variety of sports, as well as their performance during remote learning. We have nominated girls across all year groups, and we will start with lower two. Maria Ali, Maya Finn, Sayo Shiozaki, and Tilda Okocha. And the winner goes to Sayo Shiozaki. Upper two nominations are Claudia Bilecki, Bella Ferrari, Myla McCann, and Alani Rankrull. The winner is Claudia Bilecki. Form 3 nominations are Sherry Ayazi, Holly Downing, Iris Campbell, Lily Wright, and Donya Assi. And the winner is Lily Wright. Lower 4 nominations are Maya Al-Khatib, Sakura Tejima, Rachel Heine, and Katarina Lincoln. The winner is Sakura Tejima. Upper four nomination goes to Helen Wright, Megan Ransom, Carlotta Vitaloni, Isabella Shah, Ella Hare, Cara Irvine, and Claudia Lozinski. The winner is Cara Irvine. Lower five nominations are Lily Reed, Mariam Kamar, Alice Hill, and Anna Spurway. And the winner is Anna Spurway. Congratulations, girls.
Sports Personality of the Year. We open this award up to all students to vote for who they would like to nominate as their year group Sports Personality of the Year. For lower two, we had in third place, Odile Freeman. In second place, we had Enya McDermott. And first place for lower two is Freya Barrett. In upper two, we had a joint second place with Isla Townend and Phoebe Phillips. First place for upper two, Marie-Helene Weil. Form 3, we have a joint second place with Solara Salvucci and Sienna St. Paul. First place for Form 3 goes to Stella Martin. Lower 4, we have 3 in second place. They go to Fern Mortimer, Katarina Lincoln, Mia DeVivno. In first place, we have Iralua Sangosanya. Upper four, we have second place, Olivia Sparks. And in first place, we have a joint vote for Naomi Lowell and Amina Hussein. Lower five, we have a joint second with Amelie Varden and Anna Spurway. And first place goes to Chloe Bethula.
Together, come on. I'm delighted to present the next award of this evening, the Outstanding Contribution Award. In the junior school, the nominations are Enya McDermott, Myla McCann, Claudia Bilecki, Isla Townend, and Marielle Weil. And the winner is Myla McCann. And now the Outstanding Contribution for the Senior School. The nominations are Sakura Tejma, Lily Wright, Isabella Gallagher-Rattan, Heidi Hinsley, Caitlin Gallagher-Rattan, Stella Groniger, Zainab Malik, Isabel Jeffries, and Sienna St. Paul. And the Outstanding Contribution goes to Isabel Jeffries.
It's my pleasure this year to be awarding the Team of the Year, and this is given to a team who've either demonstrated progress or excellence over the season. This year, the nominations are the Under 11 Netball Team, the Under 14 Hockey Team, the Under 14 Netball Team, or the Cross Country Team, specifically the Mixed Team Relay. And the winner this year was debated long and hard, and we've decided to this year award it to the mixed team relay from the cross country team, which consists of Evie Ward, Mia DeVivno, Olivia Sparks, Amelie Vardun, and Joanna Duran. And this is because of their excellent commitment, progress throughout the year, and also the mixed team relay is a really highly competitive arena, and we saw many of the fastest splits from these girls across all of those girls who competed. So congratulations to our Team of the Year for our mixed team cross country.
This year, we are awarding three special recognition awards for achievement in sport outside of school. The first recipient is Hannah Campbell in Form 3. Hannah's been doing ballroom dancing since April 2017, and in that time, she has come first place in ballroom and second place in Latin in the grand finals in Blackpool. She's also recently just been awarded the Rising Star by her dance company. Congratulations, Hannah. Brilliant achievement. The second recipient of the Special Recognition Award is Millie Vardun, Lower 5. In 2 years, Millie has gone from finishing 21st place in the Middlesex County Championships backstroke to this year coming first place and winning the gold medal. On top of that, she also won two bronze medals and a silver in backstroke and freestyle, and she's now one of the best swimmers in London and came the top 10 in the Irish Nationals. She's also represented Ealing Borough twice in cross-country events, narrowly missing out on selection for Middlesex in the National Cross Country Championships. Congratulations, Millie. Another fantastic achievement. Our third and final recipient of the Special Recognition Award is Erin McCarthy, Upper 5. Erin McCarthy is an Irish dancer who is the current British champion. She just keeps on winning. Every time she enters an event, she wins it. She unfortunately was due to be going to the World Championships in April, which were due to COVID, unfortunately cancelled. So hopefully next year, she'll smash it. Congratulations, Erin. A brilliant achievement.
And now it's my great pleasure to announce the nominees for Junior Sportswoman of the Year 2020. Vanessa Saud, Marie-Helene Weil, Freya Barrett, Enya McDermott, and Isla Townend. And the winner this year's Junior Sportswoman of the Year 2020 is Vanessa Saud. It's now my great pleasure to read out the nominations for this year's Senior Sportswoman.
Sportswoman of the Year Award 2020. The nominations are Olivia Sparks, Naomi Lowell, Chloe Bathula, Millie Vaden, Mia DeVivino, and this year's Senior Sportswoman of the Year is Olivia Sparks. Congratulations, Olivia!
And that concludes Sports Awards 2020. Congratulations to all of our winners. And congratulations to all of you who were nominated and didn't win. Set your sights on next year. And I urge all of you who have taken part in sport throughout this year, who've represented the school, take great pride in everything you've done. We are certainly very, very proud of you. And on that note, I thought I would read you a beautiful quotation from St. Augustine in these times where we can't travel. People need to travel to wonder at the height of mountains, at the huge waves of the sea, at the long course of the rivers, at the vast compass of the ocean, at the circular motion of the stars, and yet they pass by themselves without wondering. And one reason I love that is because it's all about the magic of wonderment. And I have looked on this year, as every year, in wonderment at your achievement, each and every one of you, and also at all that the members of staff have achieved with you. And so my warmest thanks to the whole of the P department, to our coaches, to everybody who's contributed to your success this year, to Mrs. Gosling, and as she picks up the baton, Miss Novikoska. And thank you finally to parents. Your support, unwavering, unstinting, and constant, is an equal part of the great success our girls enjoy. Congratulations to everybody. Good evening.
Star of the Road by Ivy. I'm a cat, slinking in the shadows, chasing after prey. I'm an eagle, flying high, flying strong. I'm a tiger, running through the damp rainforest, sprinting, running, running. Star of a road, my train has hit the concrete as I run, run, run. I run on the soft ground, I run on the hard ground. As the sun floods my way, I can see the cat. I can see the eagle, I can see the tiger, telling me to keep going, don't stop.